if we are talking of neurogenic foot drop caused by a nerve injury, it is the lateral popliteal nerve which gets injured around the neck of the fibula. It can be traumatic, it can be non-traumatic. In the non-traumatic is a condition when a peripheral nerve entrapment syndrome can take place. If a patient has been subjected to a flexed, abducted position of the hip joint and some hard structure is pressing upon the neck of the fibula, you can get a lateral popliteal palsy because of direct pressure on the neck of the fibula. Rarely, very rarely though, a tumor of the neck of the fibula or upper end of the fibula can also cause lateral popliteal palsy. Nice to explore it. If it is traumatic or even non-traumatic, it's nice to explore, release the nerve. And lateral popliteal nerve can be very easily given release by excising the upper end of the fibula carefully. Then the moment you remove the upper end of the fibula, there's enough space for the lateral popliteal nerve. In so-called peripheral nerve entrapment syndrome, we could have mentioned the same thing for the radial nerve as well. Let's say a patient is comatose. A patient is on heavy sedatives. You can be lying down in funny posture, causing pressure on the radial nerve. Let's say in extended and widely abducted upper limb. Similarly, the lateral popliteal nerve can be pressed in a flexed and abducted position of the knee area. But don't forget the peripheral neuropathy in a diabetic state.
Among the tendon injury, what is it that a student should remember? Flexor tendon injuries of hand.
Well, most of the injuries are sharp wound injuries, compound fractures, knife cuts or something like gunshot, but in gunshot the damage would be much more than sharp cuts. And well, at some stage we used to get a lot of damage to the flexor group of muscles of the forearm due to workman's ischemic contracture. Now I think because medical facilities are available even in a resources constrained area, people don't get so much of workman's ischemic contracture. Earlier we used to get workman's ischemic contracture is a very common condition because of tight splintage done on the forearm for any injury around the elbow or forearm or even wrist.
Tight cast.
Yeah, tight cast. But if a tendon is cut, it's nice to repair. One can, of course, difficult. Yes.
Let's see. Spina ventosa.
Spina ventosa. Spina ventosa, yeah. Spina ventosa just means a spindle-shaped swelling of any small tubular bone. It can be a spindle-shaped swelling of phalanges or spindle-shaped swelling of metacarpals or tarsals. It just means a spindle-shaped swelling. And one of the common causes of a spindle-shaped swelling, so-called spina ventosa, is tuberculosis in our country, but probably rarely same thing can happen by other infective processes as well.
Tendon injury. In your experience, do they require any surgical management or the medical management?
If you are in doubt about the diagnosis, biopsy is mandatory. And if you are doing a biopsy, you can as well do a decompression, curettage and decompression. And if you obtain a tissue for biopsy, you must subject this material to microbiological studies, histological studies, if possible, serological studies. As clinicians, we feel happy if we get a positive result out of these three tests, but there would be cases in which none of these tests will be contributory. And that is the time when your clinical assessment is supreme.